The congregation, please rise as we join together in our opening hymn as printed in the bulletin, How Great Thou Art.
Bernard Andrew,
was born on October 20th, 1935, in Madonna, Missouri, to Frank and Dulcie White Andrew. He was baptized and confirmed into the Christian faith on February 7th, 1960. He married Bernita Luna on September 19th, 1954, in Unionville, Missouri. Bernard was a lifelong farmer who farmed the ground while also raising hogs. In his earlier years, he enjoyed traveling, which included road trips with friends and hunting and fishing. He also held many offices in the Lutheran Church at that time. Bernard liked to do things with his grand and great-grandchildren and also watch Westerns. Watching Hawkeye sports with his wife was also something he enjoyed. Bernard was called to his eternal home on Saturday, September 25th, 2021. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In holy baptism, Bernard was clothed with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all his sin. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. The Lord is my shepherd. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He restores my soul. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, for you are with me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Bernard and to all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. The Old Testament reading comes from the book of Job, the 19th chapter, beginning at the 23rd verse. Oh, that my words were written! Oh, that they were inscribed in a book! Oh, that with an iron pen and lead they were engraved in the rock forever! For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, yet in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me. This is the word of the Lord. I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from?
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot slip. The epistle reading comes from Paul's letter to the church in Rome, the 8th chapter. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We rise for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel comes to us according to St. John, the third chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "No one has ascended into heaven except he who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment. The light has come into the world, and people loved the darkness rather than the light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his works should be exposed. But whoever does what is true comes to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that his works have been carried out in God." And this is the gospel of our Lord. God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, it is with heavy hearts that we gather together in church today, because today we gather to say goodbye to Bernard. Sometimes as Christians, we think that it's wrong or sinful to feel sadness or sorrow when a loved one dies. We know God's promises. We know that we should rejoice in Bernard's Christian faith, and that he now resides in that eternal paradise of heaven. And we think that somehow our tears, our sorrow, our pain show a lack of faith or trust in God's word. But that's not at all true. Death causes us pain and grief. It causes us so much sorrow as we are separated from those we love, even if it is just for a short while. It's not wrong to feel that heartache, to shed those tears, to miss Bernard and all those who are no longer with us in this world. But as Christians, knowing Bernard's faith, we do not mourn as those without hope. For in Christ alone, we have assurance of everlasting life. And we know that by the grace of God, we will once again be reunited with all our loved ones who have died in the one true Christian faith. But until that day, we are right to weep and mourn, because Bernard was a blessing to us. He was a gift from God that death has taken away from us. And so today we gather together here at his funeral for comfort and for strength, not just from one another, but from God himself, as he comes to us in his holy word, as he gives us the comfort that this world cannot, And as he repeats his glorious promises that are given to Bernard and all of us, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. Often at a funeral, especially on TV and in the movies, friends and family will show the love that they had for the person who died by giving a speech called a eulogy. And eulogy simply means good word. And it's called that because that's what people say. Those who are mourning the death of their loved one will share stories, recount good memories, even talk about how great of a person they were and how much they will be missed. Everyone speaks a good word about the person who they love who's died. And there's nothing wrong with doing that. Today, as we gather for lunch, over the next few days and weeks as we visit with one another, we'll share those fond memories and stories about Bernard's life. We'll look back on all the good times we had with him. We, too, will speak a good word about Bernard and give thanks to God that we were allowed to share so many precious minutes with him. But the fact is, all the good words that we may speak, any eulogy that we might give, it simply can't compare to the good words spoken about Bernard by God himself. All of our good words, our reminiscing, our memories, they're just that. Memories. But the word of God, it is far greater than our word. The word of God has power. Power to create, power to change. And by grace alone, Bernard, even though he was a sinner like you and me and everyone else, Bernard was loved by God. Loved enough to be called God's dear child. God's own word assures us of this fact in 1 John chapter 3. See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. God's good word of forgiveness, life, and salvation, it proclaims us sinners to be forgiven and restored, renewed as his own dear children. And unlike our words, which may offer a hope or a wish for one another, God's word of power changes everything. See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. God's word has spoken, and so it is. We sinners, who rightly deserve only God's wrath and punishment, we are forgiven. We are cleansed by the blood of Jesus Christ. We are proclaimed to be the holy, innocent children of God. And because God's word has power, because God himself has proclaimed it, we have no reason to doubt. We can stand here boldly in the valley of the shadow of death and proclaim that we fear no evil, for God is with us. We can look death in the eye and know that it has been defeated by the cross and empty tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. We can know that because of our sin, we too will die. But we do not despair because of our faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus. He has given his eulogy. He has spoken his good word to us. And he has spared us from sin, death, and the devil, giving each of us the eternal victory, forgiving us of all of our sin, giving us peace even in the face of death itself. So often at funerals, we lament the things that we wish we had said to our loved one. So many eulogies contain that sad statement, "I wish I could have told him while he was alive." Well, here too is where God's eulogy is far greater than ours. Because God did not wait until today to speak his good word to Bernard. On February 7th, 1960, as Bernard was cleansed with the eternal waters of baptism, God spoke and said, "I have called you by name, you are mine." In church for so many decades, God spoke to Bernard through pastors proclaiming, "I forgive you all your sin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." In the Lord's Supper that Bernard received in church, at home, in the nursing home, wherever he happened to be, God spoke to Bernard his good word, proclaiming, "This is my body, this is my blood, given and shed for you for the forgiveness of sins." And on Saturday evening, as Jesus Christ came to carry Bernard in his loving arms to his eternal home in heaven, God spoke once again, saying to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. the good word of God, his word of power and grace and forgiveness. It was spoken boldly to Bernard all throughout his life. And that same word is spoken to each and every one of us as well. God, our beloved Heavenly Father, speaks his word through the church, through Holy Scripture. He proclaims to all us sinners that he has come to us in the flesh, that he has paid the full penalty of our sin, and he has given us the free and undeserved gift of heaven. He has spoken his word that breaks our stony, rebellious hearts, convicts us of our sin, and then shows us that that sin is forgiven. He fills us with his Holy Spirit, pours out his love upon us, and calls us his dear, beloved children. And because he has, we know that we will be with our Heavenly Father and with all our brothers and sisters in Christ forever in his perfect paradise of heaven. For now, we certainly and rightly mourn Bernard's death, and we will shed tears for weeks, even years to come. When we see something that reminds us of him, when we hear a particular phrase that he used to use, as we look back in fondness at all the good times we had with him and realize that he is no longer with us, we will grieve and we will mourn. But by the grace of Jesus Christ, we know that that mourning is only for a brief time. We rejoice that by faith, redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ, united with him in his death and his resurrection, we know that death can only separate us temporarily. And we eagerly await that glorious reunion in heaven with Bernard and with all who have died in the Christian faith. And there in heaven, we will know true joy and peace and paradise for all eternity. No more growing old or getting sick. No more slowing down and not being able to do the things that we love. No more pandemics or pain or sorrow or death. No more sin. Only the eternal, perfect joy of gathering with all the saints, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, evermore praising God, being in his holy presence, seeing him with our own eyes, and hearing with his own ears his glorious good word for all eternity. All because God has spoken his eulogy, his good word of grace and mercy to each of us, the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. See what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. For by the cross of Jesus Christ alone, by his empty tomb alone, you are forgiven of every one of your sins, and eternal life in heaven is yours. To God alone be all glory, now and forever. Amen. And now that peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in true faith in Christ Jesus. Amen. We rise for prayer. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and praise for the life you granted your servant Bernard. We thank you for all the blessings you poured out upon each of us through him, and for all the joyous memories of him that we will cherish. We thank you especially that by your word, you proclaimed your precious gospel message of forgiveness in many ways throughout his life. Give to us the peace that comes from knowing your word and having real faith in it, that we may have true comfort in times of sorrow. Lord, in your mercy, be with us in our grief, O Lord. Give to us that consolation and peace which can come only from you. Strengthen our faith, lift our hearts, and give to us absolute assurance of life everlasting, sealed for us by our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Direct our saddened eyes to your cross, that we may know true peace and joy, even in our darkest of days. Lord, in your mercy. Amen. Most merciful God, we rejoice that you have come to us in the flesh, that you have taken upon yourself the sins of the world, and that you have won for each of us the free gift of salvation. Lead us by your word to live lives that proclaim that forgiveness to all those around us. Help us to live by your word throughout our lives in all of our thoughts, words, and deeds. Speak through us in what we do and what we say, that others may hear your word and be brought to true faith in Christ. Lord, in your mercy. O Lord of mercy, we pray for all those who do not trust in your love and forgiveness. By your word, work faith in the hearts of those who do not believe, and turn back the hearts of those who have strayed from your teachings. Open their eyes to see your truth, that they may not find themselves in eternal condemnation upon their death, but may live in the constant assurance of your promise of salvation through Jesus Christ alone. Speak your word through us, that they too may rejoice with us in your love, both here on earth and for all eternity in heaven. Lord, in your mercy. Comfort us, O Lord, in the days and years ahead as we mourn Bernard's death. Give us the comfort that this world cannot give as you speak to us by your word. Touch our hearts, fill us with faith, and lead us to look forward to that glorious reunion of all believers on the last day. Lord, in your mercy. All this and whatever else you know that we need, we ask in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. And dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord. Amen.
The congregation, please remain standing for our closing hymn as printed, I'm But a Stranger Here.